An export research lab is a research facility that looks at sports performance and injury prevention. We want to understand the needs of the athlete as well as the demands imposed by the sport. In basketball, there's a number of tools we can use. We can use something like high-speed video that allows us to film at a very high rate of speed and see things you can't see with the naked eye. We can look at things like how much compression of a midsole occurs or how much shear is happening on the upper of the shoe or in the midsole, or how much is the shoe torquing if it's not built optimally. We can look at things like cushioning characteristics. It tells us the three-dimensional forces that the ground puts into the foot and ultimately through the shoe. We can use plantar pressures or even external pressure measurements to look at how the anatomy is reacting to the different cushioning elements. Are they too hard, too soft? Are they properly located and positioned?
If you watch a soccer player who does, he has twice as much torque in his ankle as we do, they're able to manage just fine. So when I got to thinking about doing it and all the positives that you can gain from it, you know, your ankle being able to perform in its natural state, the shoe being a lot lighter, you know, the one question I had is, can we go to a lower cut shoe but still not lose the cushioning, you know, that I like to have?
Kobe requested a very low-profile shoe, and it's very similar to being in a car. I mean, if the higher a car is, the more you're going to feel like you don't have that stability. You can't take a standard high top and just cut the collar off and say, "Great, I've got a low-top shoe." You need to build it from the ground up, and that was sort of what was exciting when we started working on the Kobe product. And there are millions and millions of people playing soccer in low-top shoes. I mean, I've yet to see a high-top soccer shoe, and I think that was sort of the reasoning. I mean, they certainly changed direction a lot. They step on people a lot. They have to control the ball, and they don't seem super concerned about rolling their ankle all the time. A player in the NBA might change direction upwards of 30 times on a given possession. You have to react in a split second, break, change your entire momentum, all while controlling a basketball. There's a lot of coaches and trainers out there who will judge a player on how much they can lean into their shoe, or, you know, they don't look at it in terms of how much they lean into the shoe, but they want to be able to see a player that can create that angle with the floor and push off and change direction. Something we'd already been talking about in the lab is, why would you want to fight the shoe? If I'm going to do that many cuts in a game and I don't have to fight the shoe every time I do that, there's going to be an initial benefit. If you ask a lot of basketball players, they say, "I never cut on my heels, I'm a 4-foot cutter." There's a perception there, but I can show any player that he'll actually do it a ton in a game. So as you come in and cut and you hit the ground, what you want a sort of a smooth transition. If the shoe's too hard, the shoe will snap over, and there's a feeling of, not only does that, if it snaps you over faster, there's increased risk of injury, but it's just there's a medial lateral transition that you want to have in a shoe that makes it feel like it's not a board under your foot. And by sort of breaking the midsole up, what it allows it to do, and even by scoring the side of the midsole around here, it makes it a little softer, and as you come in, this part of the midsole is able to sort of conform with the ground and provide a very smooth transition and allow the shoe to stay with your foot. The goal of containment is to provide a one-to-one fit so that when you make a cutting movement and you have those high forces, that your foot doesn't slide around. As you put that force in, obviously we want to make sure there's good traction so that the shoe sticks on the ground, and now all of that force is somewhere contained between your foot and the shoe, and your foot wants to go that way with 400 pounds of force. This has to be able to contain the foot. There's a number of things that we do to provide the strength and the containment. One of them is flywire, which are these high tensile strength cables inside the shoe that provide that support in a lightweight package to hold your foot over the footbed.
That gives the stability to the shoe that we're looking for. That's why it's able to be so light, because the flywire technology will still protect you and hold you in there where you need that stability, but at the same time, it's a lightweight material.
The cables are oriented against the direction of force that you might see in a cutting movement. So as you come in and your foot is inside and there's all that force going this way, sort of through the foot initially, the cables, we have some oriented against those lines of pull. The glove fit is sort of this one-to-one containment that we're able to sort of almost provide a second skin over the foot. It's very similar to a football boot. It provides a one-to-one fit, and you know, it's a much tighter last, and these players have come to demand it over time so that as they're playing their game, they don't slide around inside the shoe and they have a better feel for the game, whether that's ball contact or feel for the ground. They demand that one-to-one fit, and that's what Kobe was looking for. And basketball players, anytime that you plant and your foot moves inside, and you know, there's that, even if the shoe stays on the ground, you've lost a little bit of that force that you were pushing off. It's like having a seatbelt that goes to your passenger chair. you're still going to slide across in the event of a side-on collision. What you want is that to come completely around you and completely envelop you in the event of a car seat or your foot. And that's why these cables sort of try and get around and under the foot, and the reason we sculpted the arch, so that you do get that containment, that absolute lockdown around the foot. We have just strategic elements that are designed, you know, not only to provide support as an outrigger, but as they extend up, they increase the stiffness of the sidewall sort of through the midsole and prevent that from collapsing. And then there's just the very simple, you know, kick on the back is back to that leaping angle. When you come in like this, you still want some cushioning there, even though we might not be able to push the airbag all the way to the back. That midsole has to conform, provide smooth transition, and moderate those forces that are coming up. And at 10.6 ounces, I think it's pretty amazing.
You know, the lighter the shoe is, the less resistance you have. It's just as simple as that.
I mean, it's a bit of an illusion when you pick it up. There's this expectation that it's going to be more than it is. If he ever has to think about the shoe in the game, we need to get better. You know, there should never have to be a consideration other than after the fact, wow, I couldn't have done that without the shoe.